Hello guys, welcome back. It's another beautiful day over here, just over here. I don't know for the rest of the Greece. And I have my trustful companion, Wolf, which has his ball right here. He's guarding his ball. That's a dog. A dog. He's lovely. So, let him wolf enjoy his ball and his rest and come back to our project. In today's video I'm going to begin to make the masts. Don't know exactly sorry guys how many sessions I'm going to need. Definitely are going to be easier than the mass of previous models that I have made, but they will require a lot of work. So let me get ready, gather my materials, and I'll get back to you to begin. So guys, the plans are mixed up, easy to read but mixed up. So I will make three masks at the same time, but I'm only going to make with you one. First, we have to begin by cutting the pieces that we need. The mast. This is the foremast, the front one. The number is M12. M12 is 6 millimeters by 190. So 6 millimeters is this one. Got this. Now guys, let me show you some things. Here we have one of the masts. Here we have the platform, and here we have the connection between the first level of the mast with the second. Here you can see we have a square, and here we see we have a hole, a round hole. The square goes over to this. So from this point and up, this must be done in a square form to fit inside this hole. So first of all, we have to trim it. As I can see, doesn't need a lot. Here we have 6 millimeters. Here we still have 6 millimeters. Here it's hard, so I'm going to measure it from here. Here it's 5.5. So I have to trim it just a little. 5.5. Just a little. So let's do it. Now the hard part. We have a platform here, so let me measure this right. From this point must be square. This pointed up. It's not very hard, just need some precision. Okay. Now, all I need to do is trim it. Perfect. Now guys, next step. This is round. Do not glue this or you'll be in big trouble. I have to make the platform. After I make the platform, I will place it in position and then I proceed to glue the rest of the pieces that I need for the first part of the mast. So this goes to side. Here we have the platform. This is the platform for the first, for the front mast. And as I can see, we will need bending also. I hear, see here, we'll need some bending, 1/3. Okay. I need to set up my soldering iron. Give me a moment. The bending is going to be very easy, but before doing the bending, you have to make some measurements. So you begin at one end, leave a little excess here, mark the area where you're going to bend, and after you bend this and make it fit, come, glue the rest, not glue, sorry, measure the rest and mark the second area where you need to bend. Everything is going to be easy. This is a very flexible wood and very easy to bend. No need to film it. Let me do that and I'll get back to you to show you the finishing result. And here we are. Now, let's proceed. Have to place a couple of pieces of this type here. Have some rails too, but before proceeding the rails, we must make the underneath part. It's a little bit confusing, so give me a moment to find out and I'll get back to you. So guys, just something you should know. These are going underneath and these are prefixed and goes vertical and insert in the in they have already cuts and they fit perfectly. This is wrong. You can see here rails, this is the upper side, but these two pieces are underneath. So, better be careful with that. Let me make the other one, and I'll get back to you to make to place the rails. Let's place some rails. Perfect. Let me do the other one and I'll get back to you. Now, let's proceed. This platform will go here, like this. It must be glued like this, in a vertical position, and underneath the platform, we must place these pre-cut pieces vertically, like this, to hold it in position. This requires many angles, turn around the mast, so I will be able to make sure that the platform is not only centered but also vertical to the mast. So it's not going to happen on camera. After all, it just needs gluing. It's nothing hard. So let me do them and I'll get back to you to continue, because we have many more things to place on the mast. So guys, this is where we are at the moment. Have a long way to finish the mast, but let's continue. Now, what we have to place here, it's these supports, two, one on each side, this support on the front, this on the rear. This on the front and this on the rear won't be placed at this moment. Why? Because as you can see here, we have some threads that will have to pass around the mast. So if I place these pieces now, I'm going to have problem with the threads. So this will be placed later. Now we're going to place this one, and I see here also a metallic wire that must go after. Okay, we have a long way ahead. So let's place these pieces first. These pieces are the M21. M21 is 1x5. So it's this. No, this is 2x5. We want 1x5. 1x5 is this one. This is the 1x5. First of all, let me make another one and I'll get back to you. So guys, I have placed the two pieces, also placed this little small piece, nothing particular about that, and I'm ready to make the second level of the mast. As you can see, I have already cut the size, the piece in size. I just measured up again. It begins at 5 millimeters, ends at 4.5, so there's nothing difficult about that. This is the first model that I have encountered that has a so easy mast to make. So what I'm going to do now is just trim it a little bit and make it smooth. Quick and easy job. Give me a moment to see what we need and I'll get back to you. So I place this one. Also, you have to open up a little bit the hole here to make it fit. It's not hard. I have to align it. Definitely I have to align it. And I'll get back to you to place the third and final piece of the mast. And after that, it's going to need varnish and of course place all the rings, ropes and stuff that we left behind. So, let me do that and I'll get back to you. So guys, I'm up to the third part. I just figured out how to do something. As you can see here, at this point, the mast gets a little thinner and has a small step. I have managed to make the step, and this is the way to do it. With a beautiful little step. So let me place that on and I'll get back to you. And this is it guys, with a beautiful step over here. Also I placed a small nail here at the top to make everything stick. This is the foremast, the front one. It's partial finished, the woodwork that is. What needs to be made is to place couple of supports here, but these supports will be placed after the varnish, and of course after I place the ropes, because we have to place a lot of ropes around here. So this was the first one of making the mast. I have to make two more like this one. Thank you very much for watching guys. I will see you in the next phase, where the mast will be varnished to continue and finish them. Until then, see you soon and stay safe.